Hey guys, this video is about the turning gear operation. A turning gear is an independent motor used for turning the main engine when the latter is at standstill. Now, when the engine is running, the pistons are working in the firing order and transmitting the necessary power to keep the crankshaft turning. But when the engine is stopped and if we need to turn the engine to bring it to a particular crank angle, it is done by this relatively much smaller looking motor called the turning gear motor. The starter box is located right next to it, and from here it can be operated in local and remote mode. The turning gear construction is such that it can be engaged or disengaged by the operation of a lever or a wheel. The profile of the gear or teeth of the turning gear and that of the main engine flywheel are matched during the construction so as to allow a sufficient working surface for the load transfer. Today, I plan to carry out a routine crankcase inspection, so I will need to turn the engine for that. Other reasons why it could be necessary to turn the engine can be, for example, before departure from a port, after arrival at a port, before and after any major overhaul, during scavenger inspections, etc. What you see right now is the connecting rod of the main engine. We have just arrived in port. After receiving the finish with engine command, we have stopped main lube oil pumps. Following that, the normal finish with engine routine has been carried out, and now the crankcase door has been opened up because, as I said, I plan to carry out a routine monthly inspection. I know it's an absolute crime to hold the camera in vertical, but the engine is so huge that I can't really fit what I want to show in the horizontal frame. Well, this is a 9-cylinder 2-stroke man BMW marine diesel engine. It takes around 9 minutes to turn the engine one revolution using the turning gear. You can see the crosshead guide, the connecting rod, the webs, the piston rod, the piston foot, the piston and the crosshead, lubrication, inlet and outlet arrangements right now. All the moving parts are tightened hydraulically to around 2000 bars as per the specification from the maker. All the way down is the oil pan or the sump connection where the oil falls down, so to speak, after doing its job in the crankcase. From there, the main lube oil pump takes suction and puts the oil back in the closed lube oil system. Hey there, thank you so much for watching. In case you liked the video, please do subscribe. Also, if there's a comment or any feedback or a question that you have about the video, please do post below. Thank you.